Hey everyone, and welcome to the very first Arts First virtual tour. My name is Athena Yee. I'm a sophomore at the college and a very proud member of the Crimson Key Society. Although I myself am not artistically talented by any means, I have the wonderful job of introducing this tour to you all today. This tour will feature our very talented Crimson Key Society members as they take you to their favorite spots on Harvard's campus, with each spot relating to their area of expertise. We hope you enjoy watching this video as much as we enjoyed making it. Without further ado, let's make a smooth transition to learn about some jazz with my good friend, Josh Fang.
Hey everyone, my name is Josh. I'm currently a sophomore at the college and a member of the Crimson Key Society. At Harvard, my big music activity was piano, namely jazz piano. So I was involved in Harvard's jazz band, which is directed by Yosvani Terry. I was also a member of several smaller jazz groups that were funded by some alumni. And finally, I even took composition classes from Harvard's music professor, Vijay Iyer, who is one of the most famous contemporary jazz pianists alive. It was an honor to take his class, and I was exposed to tons and tons of new types of music I'd never heard before. So behind me here, we have Harvard's practice rooms. This is the main music building. So there's around 30 practice rooms here that all Harvard affiliates are welcome to use. You basically just walk in, sign in quickly, and take any room that's available. All of the rooms have pianos. They're all tuned regularly, which is obviously important. And the coolest thing about these practice rooms is they have these built-in control panels where you can adjust the acoustics of the room. So you can make it sound like you're playing in a practice room, or you can make it sound like you're playing in a cathedral or even like a massive stadium. So there's lots of cool stuff for you to play around with. Also, if you're interested in recording any types of music, can be done in these rooms as well. A few of my favorite memories from Harvard's music department. One was, like I said, the composition class I took, where essentially it was a small group around 10, 15 kids. And our professor, Vijay, would just stick us into these small ensembles, and he would put instruments together that really didn't fit naturally. So I remember one time I was in a group where it was me, my friend Luke on steel pan, and my friend Rhea, who is an incredible guitarist, classical guitar. And so the three of us would get together in these exact practice rooms and try to figure out how to make a piece that would sound good with all three of us. And it was a lot of experimentation and also a lot of learning about new types of music for me, new types of cultures and new types of musicians. So that was a massive learning experience. And I think if I had never come to Harvard, never had the opportunity to take that class, I would have never gotten to hear any of that kind of music before. If any of you are interested at all in hearing about Harvard's instrumental music, interested in jazz, I would encourage you to go to Luis Perdomo's masterclass. He's a pianist from Venezuela. It's on Saturday, April 24th at 2 p.m. Some of my friends from the jazz band will be there playing with him. It should be a fantastic opportunity to see the caliber of musicians that Harvard brings to teach its students. And with that, I'll pass it on to Kate Klein to talk about the Crimson. Bye.
Hey guys, I'm Kate. I'm a sophomore at the college, a member of the Crimson Key Society, and a writer at the Harvard Crimson, which is what I'm going to talk to you about today. So this building that you see right here is one of my personal favorite buildings on campus, 14 Plimpton Street, or as we tend to call it, 14P. It is the headquarters of the Harvard Crimson, as you can tell by the name above the door. So first, I guess I'll just tell you a little bit about our lovely newspaper. It is the only breakfast table daily newspaper in Cambridge. We publish every morning, Monday through Friday. Obviously, everything looks a little bit different in the times of the pandemic, but typically we would be in this building basically all week long, putting out the Crimson. It is also the nation's oldest continually published college daily newspaper, which is pretty cool. It was founded in 1873. And fun fact, in 1873, when it was founded, it actually wasn't called the Crimson, it was called the Magenta, but it changed a couple years later. And obviously that name stuck. It has a really incredible history. Over 25 Crimson alums have gone on to win a Pulitzer, and it includes past editors like FDR, JFK, and more. It's really a group that I am proud to be a part of, but the reason that I'm talking to you about the Crimson on Arts First Weekend is that I actually write for the arts board of the Crimson. I might be a little bit biased because I love my board and I love the people that work on it, but I think we get some of the most interesting stories and interesting pitches of any of the boards. I've gotten to do everything from writing a book review to interviewing an 80s British rock photographer who worked with Queen and David Bowie. So you run the gamut completely, and it's just a fascinating place to work. Again, obviously this year our schedules have looked a little bit different, but at least during my freshman year, I was in this building every Monday night for the arts pitch meeting, and then usually here a couple other nights a week to meet with my editors, discuss whatever story we're working on, or just chat, catch up, hear what they're researching, or hear about their classes. It's a really interesting mix of a communal space where you can catch up with your peers and fellow writers, and a workspace where you can get so much done on whatever story it is that you're chasing in that moment. So it's something I'm very grateful to have found as a freshman, and definitely somewhere you'll find me for the next couple of years while I'm on campus. As for Arts First events, I would typically send you to my group's a cappella performance because we would usually be performing at Arts First Weekend, but with COVID and remote, obviously that's not the case. So I'm going to say you have to check out the Yo-Yo Ma Music and Human Connection discussion. I think it's going to be super, super interesting. And speaking of music, I'm going to throw you over to Katie, who is going to tell you about some of the amazing musical theater performances at Farkas Hall.
Hey everyone, my name is Katie. I'm a junior at the college. I'm actually currently taking some time off to work on a farm, so I apologize if you hear any bird calls or weird things. I'm outside right now. But yeah, I'm a theater, dance, and media concentrator, and I'm going to talk to you a little bit today just about the performing arts and mainly theater on Harvard's campus. I'm obviously also a member of the Crimson Key Society, but because I'm on the farm, I didn't have access to my Crimson Key hoodie, so I just substituted this red beanie to sort of give the full effect. But anyway, back to Harvard Theater. So the organizations that I'm a part of, I've done a lot of acting and directing with the HRDC, which is the Harvard Radcliffe Dramatic Club. But I'm also, as my course of study, I'm a TDM concentrator, which is theater, dance, and media, which honestly is just sort of an umbrella concentration for the performing arts here. I'm also a member of the Hasty Pudding cast. So the Hasty Pudding Theatricals is one of the big sort of musical performance groups on campus. And that definitely takes up a decent amount of my time as well. But to sort of start, I'll talk about this building that I'm quote unquote in front of, which is Farkas Hall, which is the home for both the TDM department, but also the Hasty Pudding Theatricals. So it's a really gorgeous building, as you can see. It has a state-of-the-art theater that seats over 250 people. It also has a black box theater. It's got amazing rehearsal spaces. It has an electrical shop, dressing rooms, a really gorgeous lobby, everything that you could sort of want. And then in terms of the theater, dance, and media department, which is housed here, it's actually Harvard's newest concentration, only sort of coming to be in 2015. And it was one of the reasons that I personally wanted to come to Harvard, so I could follow that course of study. So I feel super lucky. Then sort of to move on to the Hasty Pudding Theatricals, on the other hand, it's one of the oldest, it actually is the oldest theatrical troupe in the country. Its first meeting was in 1795 and their first performance was in 1844. And they've been consistently performing a show every single year since 1844, which is pretty remarkable. I must admit they did take off 2 years for each of the world wars. And then this last year where I was cast, we had to cancel our tour, even though we we performed our shows in Farkas, but we couldn't tour around New York and Bermuda, which we normally do. I have felt super lucky to be able to follow my artistic passions here at Harvard. It's an amazing space for theater especially. But if you're looking for more or you want to hear more, see more, you can check out the celebration of, let me check out the name, Celebration of Artwork on Monday, April 19th, where they're going to be bringing together a lot of the artwork that's been produced during COVID. And celebrate the ability that we've had to continue our artistic practices despite the pandemic. But for now, I'm gonna hand it off to Catherine and Abby, who will tell you a little bit more about dance.
My name is Catherine Hodakowski. I'm a rising junior at Elliott House, concentrating in economics, as well as a member of Crimson Key Society. As you can see, I've been having fun at home in Chicago, enjoying this beautiful weather. I started dancing when I was 3 years old and danced all the way through high school. When I got to Harvard, I wasn't sure what dance group might be right for me. From the modern dance company to ballet, there's something for everyone at Harvard. I found my home at Expressions, a hip-hop dance company. I didn't have much experience with hip hop going into Expressions, but have learned so much since joining. On campus, we had weekly rehearsals in the dance center that led up to our two-night performance in Lowell Lecture Hall. Since I'm at Elliott House, it was a lot of fun taking the shuttle across to the quad with other dancers. My favorite memory as a member of Expressions is definitely the opportunity to meet new people that I wouldn't have necessarily met. Members of each dance come from different concentrations and different houses. It's a unique space that gives everyone an opportunity to be creative outside of class and exercise and get some fun. Make sure to check out the Harvard Dance Project digital archive and watch some awesome dances from Harvard's different dance groups. Now off to Brendan at Holden Chapel.
Hello everyone, my name is Brendan Kiley. I'm a rising sophomore at the college. I study history with a secondary in economics. I'm part of the Crimson Key Society and I also sing in the Harvard Glee Club. Now you may be wondering, what's this building behind me? And that is Holden Chapel. And Holden Chapel is where we and the rest of the Harvard choruses rehearse. Holden Chapel was first built to be a chapel. It quickly was turned into the building of the Harvard Medical School when it was created. And today it serves as a rehearsal space and a classroom for the Harvard choruses and other groups on campus. And the Glee Club here at Harvard is the oldest college glee club founded in America, founded back in 1858. And our alumni span across the globe and across professions. A few alumni you might recognize are Teddy Roosevelt, Franklin Delano Roosevelt, and Leonard Bernstein. And for decades, we were an all-male choir, but today, people of all genders are welcome to audition for our choir. And we do continue to sing tenor bass music as we have for the past decade and a half since we began back in 1858. And what Glee Club looks like today is we rehearse three times a week for an hour and a half each time, Monday, Wednesday, Friday usually, which isn't too bad at all. We practice as a group alone, but we never perform alone. So in our concerts throughout the year, we'll perform with the other Harvard choruses, and also sometimes with glee clubs from other schools like Yale and Princeton, who aren't our favorites, but we do like to get together to sing with them. And we've been doing that for over 100 years performing with them. And those ones are a lot of fun because they're around the time of the football games with them. We travel and we have a good time with them. We also tour within the US every year and internationally every 4 years. Things are looking a little different, you know, during COVID. Virtual rehearsals aren't always the best, but our directors are doing a fantastic job. They're doing their best. We're all doing our best. But there have been really cool opportunities to connect with great composers, singers, and artists around the world because of the Zoom format. So it's really been special in that way. And we've been able to branch out and learn a lot because of the Zoom situation. One thing that I do miss that we haven't been able to do during COVID is we usually do an annual retreat down to Cape Cod, and we only go for one day and one night, but on top of rehearsal, we also have new member initiation, we have meals together, a bonfire, and plenty of fun. It's such a great way to welcome new members, and especially being a new member last year, it was such a great way, relaxed, social way to get to know the rest of the group. And that's really what it's all about, is having this community, and that's been my favorite part. I've been singing since middle school. Never really thought I would sing in college, but you know, I joined the group and have enjoyed every moment of it. So I really enjoyed my time in the Glee Club. Met some fantastic people. You know, we study all different things. Not everybody studies music. I don't. Some people do, some people don't. And that's the great thing. It's a great community of a lot of different types of people. And we, you know, kind of come together, have a great time, enjoy singing, but also enjoy just, you know, having that community and spending time with each other. So hope you've enjoyed a little bit, learning a little bit about the Glee Club. It's been a pleasure. I enjoyed it. And I'm going to hand it over to Amy now.
Wow. I really wish I could sing like Brendan. Since I reserve most of my singing for the shower, I'm here to tell you guys about a group I play violin for. My name is Amy, and I'm a sophomore at the college and a member of Crimson Key Society. I also play violin for Mariachi Veritas, which is Harvard's first and only mariachi band. Once a year, we perform here in Adams Pool House Theater. You may be wondering why pool, house, and theater are all in one name, but that's because this space used to be an actual pool. This was once the location of many rambunctious student gatherings and provided a space for personal expression and liberation for Harvard students. Fittingly, today it serves as a theater for student-led performances, movie screenings, lectures, and exhibitions. Although I'm taking a semester off from mariachi to focus on other endeavors, I always think about the fun memories I made during my first few semesters with mariachi. During the first week of my first semester at Harvard, I went to the activities fair. Given the 400 plus Harvard clubs, it was super overwhelming and I was feeling really homesick. Having played violin since I was little, I was looking to join an ensemble, but I was pretty afraid since I hadn't played in an orchestra or a formal setting since middle school. I stumbled into Mariachi's table where the group was dressed up in their trajes, which is our traditional dress, and they had their instruments. They asked me if I wanted to join and I started to nervously retreat. All of a sudden, they broke out in song and sang Cielito Lindo, which is a song my mom used to sing to me when I was really little. I almost cried since I hadn't heard the song in so many years and I missed my mom. And I thought it was a sign, so I immediately signed up for auditions. Because we're a small group, mariachi became my second family at Harvard. I actually met some of my best friends while we were prepping for our auditions together. Apart from weekly rehearsals, we would meet up for brunch every Sunday, host special gatherings as bonding events, and the upperclassmen in mariachi were always reaching out to me and the other first years to make sure that we felt comfortable and were having a great time. In addition, we would have smaller performances such as our Day of the Dead performances, in which we actually got to go out into Dorchester, which is the local Boston community, and perform at a community gathering for Day of the Dead. The upperclassmen in mariachi made me feel so welcome and comfortable, even encouraging me to try out singing for the first time. My favorite memory was during our first performance at Adams Pool House Theater. I was so nervous. This is my first real performance with the group. I had invited all of my friends, and I was singing the closing song with my friend Brian. When the time came to sing, part of me wanted to run away and ditch the concert, but I remembered how hard Brian and I had worked on the song for weeks, and I was having so much fun performing with my best friends that I actually forgot that I was nervous. Thank you so much for letting me tell you all about Mariachi Veritas. Apart from clubs, I also have a minor in film, so I encourage you to attend the Arts First Film Night on April 26th, featuring short films by Harvard students that include animation, narrative drama, and autobiographical projects. Next, we're going to hear from Alex Kim, who is going to tell you a bit about ceramics and other art forms at Harvard.
Hey guys, my name is Alex. I am a rising junior at Harvard and a very proud member of the Crimson Key Society. I'm also a ceramicist, so if you know me, you'll know that I'm generally obsessed with all things clay related, so should be no surprise that today I want to talk to you about what I consider one of Harvard's best kept secrets, the Harvard Ceramic Studio. It's slightly off the beaten path, but it is honestly one of my favorite places on campus and somewhere I've really come to call home. So it's just across the river from the main campus. It's an incredible space to make anything clay related. You can enroll in all types of courses in the fall, in the spring, even the summer. So think wheel throwing, think sculpture, glaze chemistry, mold making, honestly, anything you could dream up in clay, there's a class for it here. There's also multiple types of kiln firings, a special room for sculpture, tons and tons of wheels for wheel throwing. So, you know, if you're an aspiring Patrick Swayze or Demi Moore from Ghost, definitely the place for you. The studio also hosts incredible lectures from visiting artists, art historians, archaeologists, which I would super highly recommend. So personally, ceramics is a huge part of my life. I've been working with clay since I was 8 years old, and this studio was another huge reason that I was so excited to come to Harvard. This is a place that allows me to keep pursuing something I'm super passionate about. But so yeah, this place is really meant for you to explore and create in whatever capacity you would enjoy. So like definitely check this place out. I'll be here a lot, so say hi. Seriously, this place is amazing. I promise you won't be wasting your time. Yeah, it's great. Do it.
Now, I don't know about you guys, but I am truly blown away by how talented our members are. We hope you learned something new and that you get the chance to visit more virtual exhibits or even the physical place itself one day. To learn more about us, you can visit crimsonkeysociety.org, but to see more of the wonderful exhibits that the Marshall's office put together for us this year, you can visit ofa.fas.harvard.edu. We hope you enjoyed. Bye!